Have you seen one of these ESP01 Wi-Fi relay models? It is an interesting piece of model that is suitable for smart homes and Internet of Things projects. Let's take a closer look. As its name suggests, the major components are an ESP8266 ESP01 module and a relay. The relay is connected to the GPIO0 pin of the ESP01 through a PC817 optoisolator chip. The relay's functionality can be checked with a trigger switch, and its on and off state is indicated with an LED. The COM, NO and NC connections of the relay are available at this terminal block. The module operates with voltages from 5 to 12 volts, regulated to 3.3 volts for the ESP01 with the AMS1117 chip. You can remove the ESP01 from its socket for programming. Insert the ESP01 into the ESP01 programmer and plug it into the USB port of your computer. See purchase link in the description. You can have a network of these modules around your apartment as the basis of your home automation system to switch on and off your lighting, heating, and lots more. We are going to make a custom mobile app program for the module to operate a light bulb with remote XY and FL probe. First, start a new project on remotexy.com. Configure the connection as an access point for the ESP8266 based board. Select the Wi-Fi on chip module and FLPROG IDE. Note the access point port number from here. Then label the app as ESP01 relay. Add an edit field to delay the switching time of the lamp with the integer input type selected. Add a push switch to switch on and off the lamp. Set the draw type to rectangular and change the switch off caption to off delay. Add another rectangular push switch with the switch on caption changed to on delay. And a last rectangular push switch with the switch captions changed to blink on and blink off. Then click on Get Source Code to copy the code for use in FLPROG. Create an ESP8266 ESP01 project in FLPROG. Go to the controller Wi-Fi module settings to enable the access point. Input a network name of the ESP01 relay and a password as required. Then add a digital output of a relay assigned to GPIO0. Drag a remote XY block into the program and double-click on it. Provide a connection password if required and select the built-in Wi-Fi module. Select the access point and input port number 6377. In the Input Output tab, click on Download Description and paste the RemoteXY source code here. Observe that the RemoteXY 3 push switches and the Edit field are shown in the output section, and with their output connections shown on the block. Add a timer block to the program and configure it as a turn-off type with an external input delay. Configure another timer block as a turn-on type with an external input delay. Also, configure a generator block as a symmetrical multivibrator with an external input pulse length. Connect the remote XY push switch outputs to the EN inputs of the blocks and the edit output to the VAL inputs of the blocks. Drag an OR block and the relay output tag into the program. Right-click on the OR block to add additional inputs. Connect the output of the timer blocks to the input of the OR block and the output of the OR block to the relay output tag. Then click on the Upload button. When the Arduino IDE is displayed, ensure that the generic ESP8266 board type and the port number are selected. Also select the appropriate flash size and the reset method of your ESP01 before uploading. Insert the ESP01 back into the relay module. Connect one terminal of the light bulb to the NO terminal of the module and to 220 volts of the AC neutral line. The common terminal should go to the AC life. Then power up with a 5 to 12 volts DC power supply. Turn on your mobile Wi-Fi and connect to the ESP01 relay access points. Download the Remote XY app into your mobile phone. Add a new device and select Wi-Fi points. Input port number 6377 and select the ESP01 relay access point to connect to the module. With a zero delay time, these buttons will turn on and off the light bulb. When the delay is set in milliseconds, the first button press turns on the bulb immediately, but delays it turning off for the specified time. The second button will delay turning on the bulb, but turn it off immediately. While the last button will blink the bulb with the specified on and off duration. Thanks for watching. Please support this channel by clicking on the thanks button and get the components used in this video with the AliExpress links in the description. Also, hit the like button if this video is helpful, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you are yet to. See you in the next video.